हाय स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज श्रीनिवास, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बॉटनी। दिस वीडियो वॉज शूटेड विथ सेल फोन कैमरा, सो आई रिक्वेस्ट यू टू यूज योर ईयरफोन्स। ओके, थैंक यू। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन ए न्यू चैप्टर, माइक्रोब्स इन ह्यूमन वेलफेयर। माइक्रोब्स इन ह्यूमन वेलफेयर, फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर टू बिट्स विल कम इन इट। ओके, इन द फर्स्ट ईयर, दैट इज इन बायोलॉजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन, वी स्टडीड माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स। फाइव किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन प्रपोज्ड बाय आर एच विटेकर। हू प्रपोज्ड फाइव किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन? आर एच विटेकर। व्हाट आर दोज फाइव किंगडम्स? मोनेरा, प्रोटिस्टा, फंगाई, प्लांटे, एनिमेलिया। मोनेरा, प्रोटिस्टा, फंगाई, प्लांटे, एनिमेलिया। वी हैव टू से इन अ sequence of these five kingdoms, which kingdoms are having microorganisms, that is monera, protista, fungi. Of these three, which kingdoms are having only microorganisms, that means first two, monera, protista, that means fungi are having both microorganisms and macroorganisms. Fungi are having both microorganisms and macroorganisms. Microorganisms means which are not visible to our naked eye, which are invisible to our naked eye. Macroorganisms means visible to our naked eye. See, two questions are there. Which kingdoms among the living organisms contain microorganisms? That means monera, protista, fungi. Which are the kingdoms that are only microscopic? That means you have to say these two only. Don't say fungi here. Why? Because that fungi are having both microscopic and macroscopic. So only microscopic means monera, protista. Don't say fungi here, my dear students. Try to concentrate. Where do you find these microorganisms? Microorganisms are present everywhere. That is cosmopolitan in distribution, ubiquitous. Everywhere means in soil, in water, in air, in snow, at high temperature, like that. These microorganisms are present everywhere. What are the different types of microbes? That is bacteria, viruses, prions, viroids, fungi, protozoans, some microscopic algae. These are the different types of microbes. Microbes means which are not visible to our naked eye. Colonies are formed by. Colonies means if cell division occurs, those cells are not separated from each other. That condition only colonies are formed. Colonies means a group of cells together. Colonies are formed by which organisms? One is bacteria and second one is many fungi. So bacteria and fungi may form colonies. Which organisms may form colonies? Bacteria and many fungi. And look at this side, my dear students. See, I am going to explain lactic acid bacteria, shortly called LAB. LAB. Example, lactobacillus. Bacillus means rod shape. Based on morphology, bacteria are of four types. Spherical shaped bacteria called coccus. Rod shaped bacteria called bacilli. Spiral shaped bacteria called spirillum. Comma shaped bacteria called vibrio. So that means based on morphology, bacteria are of four types. Of those, this one is bacillus, that is rod shape. They produce a chemical called lactic acid. What is the role of this lactic acid bacteria? Converts milk into curd at suitable temperatures. How do the process occur? First of all, we have to boil the milk at high temperature. Later, at lukewarm, that is at little temperature, a small amount of curd is added as inoculum or starter. Which will be added as inoculum or starter? A small amount of curd is added as inoculum or starter. That small amount of curd contains millions of LAB. So a small amount of curd which contains millions of LAB is added to fresh milk as inoculum or starter. How do the process occur? LAB produce acids that coagulate. That is, LAB produce some acids that coagulate. Later, milk proteins are partially digested. Don't say completely digested. Milk proteins are partially digested. Don't say completely digested. And it improves its nutritional quality by increasing vitamin B12. Decreasing B12 or increasing B12. So, vitamin B12 is increased. Don't say decreasing. So increasing B12. Here it is vitamin. What is the vitamin? B12. Don't say B1. Don't say B2. It is vitamin B12. So during the growth, what are the process occur sequence? That is, first of all, lactic acid bacteria produce acids that coagulate. Next one, milk proteins are partially digested, and later that vitamin B12 is increased. These are the steps in the correct sequence. And next, lactic acid bacteria are also present in our stomach also. What is their role in stomach? That means to check the disease-causing microbes. What is their role? To check the disease-causing microbes. To check the disease-causing microbes in our stomach, that is the role of lactic acid bacteria. So this is about lactic acid bacteria. That means we are taking the curd means, we are taking the lactic acid bacteria. That means we are taking the useful bacteria. That branch is so called probiotics. What is probiotics, my dear students? Probiotics, live microbial food supplement. Here food supplement means, example, curd. So we are taking the curd means we are taking the live LAB. So many millions of LAB are taking while taking the curd. Means we are taking, that means while taking the curd means millions of LAB are taking. So that is those bacteria are useful. So useful bacteria can be studied in probiotics. What is the example of probiotics? Lactobacillus. This lactobacillus is useful in the conversion of milk into curd. Which bacteria is useful in conversion of milk into curd? Lactobacillus. Study of useful bacteria is probiotics. Study of live microbial food supplements in probiotics. This is the advanced branch in microbiology. So please note down all these points, my dear students. Some viruses are different shapes. Tadpole shaped virus, that is bacteriophage, was studied in biological classification. Bacteriophage is which shape? Tadpole shape. So tadpole shaped virus is bacteriophage. Rod shaped virus is TMV. That means tobacco mosaic virus. Rod shaped bacteria is bacilli. So try to remember these things, my dear students. TMV is rod shaped virus. True. TMV is rod shaped. True. TMV is rod shaped bacteria. It's wrong. TMV is a virus, it's not a bacteria. So TMV is rod shaped virus. What is that rod shaped bacteria? Bacillus. Singular is bacillus, plural form is bacilli. And some viruses that cause respiratory infections. What is that? Adenovirus. The virus that cause respiratory infections is adenovirus. So please note down these points, my dear students. Now I am going to explain microbes in household products. That means from the house some products are produced. What are those? The duff. Duff means, sorry, the dough which is used for making foods such as dosa and idli is fermented by bacteria by a process called anaerobic fermentation. Fermentation is a process of anaerobic respiration. How the dough will be prepared? The flour mixed with water is called dough. That dough is used for preparation of dosa and idli. For that, which microorganism is used? That means bacteria. From where does those bacteria are obtained? That means from atmosphere. From atmosphere. When we are mixing that dough, the puffed up appearance will come. The puffed up appearance of dough is due to production of CO2. Don't say CO. That puffed up appearance is due to CO2. Don't say CO. CO2 means carbon dioxide will be released. Anaerobic fermentation takes place resulting in the formation of CO2. That is, in fermentation, CO2 is evolved. CO2 is released. What is that process called? Fermentation. it is a process involved in anaerobic respiration. So which process takes place resulting in the formation of CO2 means we have to say anaerobic fermentation. Next, the bacteria for anaerobic fermentation came from, where does these bacteria are obtained from? From atmosphere. From atmosphere. The dough which is used for making bread is fermented by using a yeast called baker's yeast. So the dough which is also used for making bread also, that can be done by yeast, not by bacteria. Toddy. Toddy means it is a traditional drink which was used in southern India. Used in southern India. That will be obtained by fermenting sap from palms. Palms means Boraceous tree, belongs to family Palmaceae. So that means toddy, it is a traditional drink in southern India. It was obtained by fermenting sap from palms. Example for palms is Boraceous. Microbes are also used to ferment fish, soybean and bamboo shoots to make foods. That means microbes are also used to ferment those substances to prepare the foods. Look at that types of cheese. Cheese is one of the oldest item. Types of cheese, two types. Swiss cheese, Roquefort cheese. This Swiss cheese is obtained by a bacterium called Propionibacterium shermani. What is that bacterium? Propionibacterium shermani. See, bacterium means it is a bacteria. What is the characteristic feature of this cheese? Presence of large holes. Large holes are present in this cheese. Large holes are due to production of large amount of CO2. Don't say CO. So this Swiss cheese is obtained by a bacterium called Propionibacterium shermani. What is the characteristic feature? That is presence of large holes. These large holes are due to production of release of large amount of CO2. Next, another type of cheese, Roquefort cheese. It is obtained by, not from bacteria, it is by fungi. Try to remember, this is from bacterium and this is from fungi. That fungi name is Penicillium notatum. Penicillium notatum. So Roquefort cheese is obtained from Penicillium notatum, which belongs to fungi. Don't say bacteria. So these points are very, very important, my dear students. So that is, they will ask like this: Roquefort cheese is obtained from the bacterium Penicillium. False. Roquefort cheese is obtained from fungi Penicillium. True. So this Penicillium belongs to group fungi, not belong to bacteria. And what is its characteristic feature? It gives a particular flavor. A particular smell. Right, there are different types of cheese. So these cheese are different in their characteristic taste, flavor and specificity. And texture also different. So cheeses are different in their taste, texture, flavor, etc. So these are the different types of cheese. Please note down all these points, my dear students. Now I am going to explain microbes in industrial products. That means to produce the products in industries, microbes are used. To produce the products in industry, so microbes are used. What are they? And what do you call the vessels? Like that. Microbes are used in industrial products. Which organisms are used in industrial products? Microbes are used. What are the industrial products means? Two types. One is fermented beverages. Second one is antibiotics. See, examples of industrial products by using microbes are: one, fermented beverages; second one, antibiotics. In industry, to produce products, what are the vessels used means fermenters. These are large vessels in which microbes are grown in large number to produce the industrial products. What are the vessels used in industrial products? That means fermenters. Whether those are small vessels or large vessels, those are large vessels. See, fermenters. What are fermenters? These are large vessels in which microbes are grown in large numbers on an industrial scale. First of all, I am going to explain fermented beverages. Which organisms are used in beverages? This is very, very important, my dear students. In the formation of beverages, which microbes are used means we have to say yeast. Yeasts are used for the production of beverages. What are the different types of beverages? Wine, beer, whiskey, brandy, rum, gin, etc. So fermented beverages are produced. Some may be produced without distillation, some may be produced with distillation. These two are very, very important, my dear students. Fermented beverages without a distillation are wine and beer. There is no distillation process, that's why less percentage of alcohol is present in them. Less percentage of alcohol is found in wine and beer. What is the reason? Because those are produced without distillation. Fermented beverages are produced with distillation. What are they? Whiskey, brandy, rum, gin. These have high percentage of alcohol. Why whiskey, brandy, rum and gin have more percentage of alcohol? Because these are produced with distillation. So try to remember, my dear students, the following beverages are produced without distillation: wine and beer. With distillation, that is whiskey, brandy, rum, gin, etc. All these products are obtained by using which organism? Yeast. Is there any metabolic reaction? Yes. In respiration, we have studied anaerobic fermentation. Anaerobic fermentation. I would recall the anaerobic fermentation. What is the metabolic reaction, or what are the metabolic reactions involved in the formation of ethyl alcohol? Ethyl alcohol is also called ethanol. So metabolic reactions in the production of ethanol by using organism called yeast. Don't say here bacteria. So in the formation of ethanol, which microbe is involved? Yeast. Don't say bacteria. End product of glycolysis is pyruvic acid. From that pyruvic acid, acetaldehyde is formed. In the formation of acetaldehyde, decarboxylation occur. Decarboxylation means release of CO2. Enzyme involved is pyruvic decarboxylase. Process involved is decarboxylation. from the acetaldehyde, ethanol is produced, also called ethyl alcohol, by process called reduction. So in the formation of ethanol from pyruvic acid, initially decarboxylation and later reduction occurs. Addition of hydrogens is called reduction. Don't say oxidation. In the formation of ethanol, initially decarboxylation and later reduction occur. Together called reductive decarboxylation. Reductive decarboxylation. Here involved enzyme is pyruvic decarboxylase. Here involved enzyme is alcohol dehydrogenase. This is the metabolic reaction involved in the formation of ethanol. This process occurs by yeast only. Right. Now I am going to discuss about this yeast. What is the scientific name? Yeast scientific name is Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Saccharomyces cerevisiae. It is unicellular yeast, not multicellular. It is also called baker's yeast. It is also called brewer's yeast. Baker's yeast, brewer's yeast. It is used in bread making. The organism that is used in bread making is yeast. That is Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Don't say bacteria. The microbe used in bread making is yeast only, not bacteria. This yeast is also used in fermenting malted cereals and fruit juices to produce ethanol. Wherever the ethanol is produced, which organism is involved? Yeast only. So fermenting malted cereals and fruit juices to produce ethanol means we have to say yeast only. Don't say bacteria. This was used in commercial production of ethanol. This yeast belongs to class Ascomycetes of fungi. Which class? Ascomycetes. So yeast is commonly called baker's yeast. It is also called brewer's yeast. It is used in bread making. This point is very, very important, my dear students. Please note down all these points.